In physiology of sex hormones, we basically have three levels of regulation. The first level is hypothalamus that secretes gonadotropin-releasing hormone. The second level is pituitary gland that secretes gonadotropins. To gonadotropins we refer to hormones, it's lutenizing hormone and follicle-stimulating hormone. They are called gonadotropins because they stimulate gonads. In male, they act on testes, in women, they act on ovaries. And the third level is gonads that secrete sex hormones. So now we can discuss this process step by step. So initially, hypothalamus secretes gonadotropin-releasing hormone. Gonadotropin-releasing hormone stimulates pituitary gland to secrete gonadotropins. It's luteinizing hormone and follicle-stimulating hormone. These two hormones enter into the bloodstream where they stimulate gonads. In male, they act on testes, in women, they act on ovaries. And basically until this point, the pathway is the same for men and women. But from this moment, the pathways are different. In male, luteinizing hormone acts on leydig cells and stimulates testosterone production. It's easy to remember because of first three letters in luteinizing hormone. Luteinizing hormone stimulates leydig cells and stimulates testosterone production. And follicular-stimulating hormone acts on sertoli cells in seminiferous tubules that in response to this secrete antimullerian hormone. And antimullerian hormone promotes spermatogenesis. Now once testosterone is produced, most of testosterone molecules immediately bind to sex hormone binding globulin and albumin. In fact, 98% of testosterone in the blood is bound to plasma protein. And what we have to know is that binded testosterone is inactive. So only 2% of testosterone in the circulation is free, or we can say biologically active testosterone. Now, testosterone can be delivered to peripheral tissues, where testosterone can be converted by 5-alpha reductase enzyme to dehydrotestosterone. Also, free testosterone can be delivered to adipose tissue, and adipose tissue by extrahepatic aromatization converts testosterone into estradiol. We have to know that extrahepatic aromatization occurs mostly in adipose tissue, but also it can occur in bone cells. The reason why this process is called aromatization, if we take for example testosterone, aromatase converts non-aromaticrine in testosterone molecule into aromatic. And now this molecule called estradiol. So aromatization results in conversion of androgens to estrogens, and extrahepatic aromatization in adipose tissue is a major source of estrogens for men. And also sertoli cells secrete a substance called inhibin. Inhibin is a glycoprotein that inhibits secretion of pituitary gland. So sertoli cells that produce sperm have their own feedback mechanism by secretion of inhibin that serves as indicator of spermatogenesis. Now in females, luteinizing hormone acts on theca cells. In response to this, theca cells begin to produce progesterone and androstenedione. So to explain this, we have to know that in theca cells, luteinizing hormone stimulates cholesterol desmolase enzyme. And cholesterol desmolase converts cholesterol into pregnenolone. Theca cells have a specific enzyme, 3-beta-hydroxysteroid dehydrogenase, that converts pregnenolone into progesterone. And once progesterone is produced, they secrete progesterone into the blood. So the first option is that theca cells from pregnenolone can directly produce progesterone. But the second option is that pregnenolone, through three consecutive reactions, can be converted into androstenedione. And androstenedione is a precursor of testosterone. But the problem is that theca cells do not have any enzyme to convert androstenedione into something else. So androstenedione diffuses into granulosa cells, where 17-beta-hydroxysteroid dehydrogenase converts androstenedione into testosterone. And now granulosa cells can secrete testosterone into the blood. But the alternative option is that follicle-stimulating hormone, by stimulation of aromatase, can force granulosa cells to convert testosterone into 17-beta-estradiol. And now estradiol can be secreted into the blood. So androstenedione diffuses from thicker cells into granulosa cells, and from androstenedione, granulosa cells produce testosterone, but also follicle-stimulating hormone can force them to convert testosterone into estradiol. Also, a part of androstenedione and testosterone molecules from the blood are delivered to adipose tissue, where testosterone undergo extrahepatic aromatization with formation of estradiol. Overall, it's a minor pathway, but this pathway becomes the primary source of estrogens in postmenopausal women. If you like content, please press like and subscribe button. All the best!